We're back. Stephanie Miller, have you... There's never been anything like this, this race, right?
There has not. And I first of all want to go on record as saying Bradley Whitford is not that big a schmuck. He does not deserve a tax cut, but really, don't say that about yourself. But no, but I think your
point... The whole race.
The whole race.
Right, as Ben said.
By the way, please refer to me as Stephanie Hussein Miller from now on. my listeners are all taking the name Hussein, and one of them just named their kids Hussein. I think we should name all our kids Hussein and just completely ameliorate the issue.
Mrs. Goldberg will not do it.
Larry.
Yes, Fran.
Larry. I just want to say, La Niñera gustó mucho Hillary Clinton. Es la solución de los problemas de emigración y para evitar el abuso de las mujeres.
Happening.
I'm speaking to the Latino community.
Okay.
See,
okay.
Puede. Say it with me. All right.
Welcome back to Telemundo. That's kind of weird. But getting back, we'll figure
that
one out later.
That accent.
I think that's only because you're not bilingual.
I think she cursed.
I think she cursed Stephanie.
It became a Fellini film or Bergman or somebody, right? But Amy, this race, not only has there been nothing like it, there will be nothing like it.
Well,
wherever it goes.
You know, it's the first wide open race on both sides, in 50 years? And, you know, a year ago I would have told you it was going to be Hillary versus Giuliani. Who would have guessed it would be Barack Obama versus John McCain? His campaign was dead in the water last summer.
It's,
for political junkies, this has been, you know, like...
I talked to the absolutely number one Republican political strategist.
Hold on, friend. No, they're guessing it. They're not
I talked to one of the absolutely top big-name Republican strategists in the country, a name these people would spit at. About 6 months ago, he said McCain was gone. McCain was gone. History. And it's just amazing.
The RNC was basing their whole strategy on the idea that Hillary Clinton was going to win. Now, you know, it's a toss-up.
We'll be back with our remaining moments right after this message. Don't go away. It's Friday night. Let's have a little fun. Watch.
Mexico, lindo y querido, sin mero pleco.
Thanks for the question, you little jerk.
This pantsuit, it's asbestos tonight.
¿Qué me trae aquí?
I don't feel no ways tired. I come too far.
Memory, like the corners of my mind. Misty watercolor memories of the way we were.
Do I know how to sing? About as well as she knows how to govern America.
That sums it up, doesn't it, yeah. Stephanie? Right?
You know what it is, Larry, why there's so much excitement in this race? We cannot wait to get rid of this guy. Mr. What? Gas is $4 a gallon? Wait, well, nobody told... Boy, sucks to be without a motorcade these days, doesn't it?
He has nothing to do with the price of gasoline.
Nobody
whatsoever.
Didn't know that was pretty.
I know. He's not. I don't pretend he's incredibly well informed, but I mean, but he has nothing. It's not his fault at $4 a gallon. It has nothing to do with him or the oil companies. It's just world markets.
Did you realize though that was a little put down what you just said?
Well, I understand that. Eisenhower wasn't particularly well informed either, and he was a great president. These guys are not scholars. They're politicians. I don't think he's a great president, but he's a very nice guy.
Yeah. Well, that's enough for us.
Yes, Fran.
Thank you.
I just want to say that I really think that Barack and Hillary, in one combination or another, better be on the same ticket, because to me, that's a slam dunk.
Good luck.
Oh, wow. All right. If Barack gets a nomination, you think he'd ask Hillary to be his VP, and you think she'd accept?
I have no
Yes,
idea,
I absolutely
you know
do because
he the, need to.
Wait, I thought
I'm
he was asking me. I think that, you know, the job of vice president, that's the job that nobody wants and nobody turns down. And there's no way that Hillary is going to turn down being the first woman vice president if that's what's in the cards. Whatever it is, She's going to get her foot into that door if she can, because she's very tenacious, and you need somebody like
that. Okay, let's see
what the panel
thinks.
And if it's the other way around, so be it.
If Brock wins the nomination, he doesn't need Hillary, because he's just proven that he beat, you know, the big grill in the room, the inevitable candidate, the person with all of the Democratic apparatus behind her. He will prove that, you know, he transcends all that. However, if Hillary wins the top of the ticket, the pressure to put Barack Obama as VP will be enormous.
Brad?
I think together, they're like, everybody saw that in the debates. That they look fantastic together, and
I mean, she's at a disadvantage.
She is at a disadvantage.
I can't say.
I think what you're hearing when Democrats sort of calm down about the irrational defense of one candidate or the other is that they want a hybrid. They want this experience and they want this freshness together. I would be very excited about that ticket. I would also be excited. I think Senator Webb from Virginia would be a fantastic for either candidate vice presidential.
Or Vietnam War hero.
Novelist,
etc.
Yes.
I think at this point, Larry, Hillary has no choice. She must pick Fran Drescher.
Yeah. I accept.
After tonight, there's no.
What do you think, Ben?
Hillary, the pure negative for Senator Obama. Pure negative, polarizing, negative figure. I think your idea of Senator Webb, which I'm sure is widely publicized, is a great, super idea. I wish we had somebody like him on the Republican
side. Who would you like on the McCain ticket?
I like Governor Pawlenty of Minnesota. He's a moderate, very well-liked guy. He brings that moderate quality to the ticket, and he also is popular, I think, with the evangelicals, and I think he will consolidate the party.
Who do you like, Amy?
At this point, I don't have an opinion on this. I'm still, I have to say, not exactly in John McCain's camp. I'm getting there, like a lot of conservatives, actually.
You're not in the... Are you evangelical?
No, I'm not an evangelical, and I'm actually a registered independent, but... You know, I want to see John McCain really make the sale that he is a true conservative, that he has those economic principles in his blood. He's got some good people behind him. Ted Olson, you're friends with Ted, you know him.
Very good.
Yes.
Thank you all very much. For more on our shows and guests, go to cnn.com/LarryKing. You can download our latest podcast, Elton John. I want to remind you about the Larry King.